I'm Ellie and I've just finished my second year studying medicine.
Hi, I'm Bhuvana and I've just finished my first year studying biochemistry.
Hi, I'm Adrian and I've just finished my first year studying engineering.
So we're here to talk about genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is basically changing the DNA of an organism to give it useful properties. For example, we may want to modify an organism to make certain molecules that can be used to treat diseases, as food sources, or in industry.
So we are all taking part in the iGEM competition this year, which will mean that we are researching the genetic engineering for this whole summer, and then we will present our project at the conference in Boston in America. Our team consists of lots of different people, so we got 10 undergraduates, we've got 5 biochemists, 2 engineers, 1 medic, 1 biologist.
And a chemist.
And we are, with our project, hoping to cure autoimmune diseases. So an autoimmune disease is when the immune system attacks itself. Examples of this would be Crohn's disease or irritable bowel syndrome, which quite a lot of people have. So in a healthy person, there is a certain balance between two molecules called interleukin-10 and interleukin-17. However, in a person with an autoimmune disease, they have a misbalance of these two molecules. So they will usually have too much of interleukin-17. So what we're hoping to create is a bacterium which will detect this misbalance, and it will detect when there's too much of the molecule called interleukin-17. And in response to that, it will create more of interleukin-10, which will recreate the balance which we would find in a healthy person. And our bacterium would be different from most other ones because it would give the correct dose of interleukin-10 to match how much interleukin-17 is raised in a certain person.
So I chose to do iGEM because I thought it'd be a really interesting experience to work with students from other subjects, because I thought I'd be able to learn a lot through them. And I think as well, as I said before, I study medicine, but a lot of the information that we get in our course is just based upon how the body works. And I think it's really interesting to look at how different aspects of science can be used to influence medical treatment today.
I chose to do iGEM because I wanted some experience of working in a lab. And I think this is a really great program because it allows you to develop your own project with other students. And iGEM is really great because it involves tackling real-world issues.
I chose iGEM because although I am an engineering student, I am very, very interested in using my engineering skills to tackle medical problems, because I think those are some of the most important problems that we could tackle in the world. And I feel that the engineering course, especially during the first 2 years at Oxford, doesn't really cover much medical engineering, and I really wanted to get some of that element.
So we spent a lot of time looking at different areas which we could do our project in. So another one we were looking at is the environmental impact of genetic engineering. For example, we can change the DNA of bacteria to make them produce bioplastics. These are plastics which can easily be broken down in the environment, so they won't take up space in landfills, and which don't require the use of non-renewable fossil fuels. There are also many agricultural applications of genetic engineering. For example, we may want to change plants to give them resistance to certain chemicals, allow them to grow in certain conditions, or to grow to a very large size.
There are also lots of medical applications to genetic engineering, and one of the most well-known ones is the production of insulin by E. coli, and so that's had huge effects on helping patients with diabetes. And there are also lots of new research studies taking place at the moment, such as engineering mosquitoes to stop them from carrying the malaria parasite. Obviously, genetic engineering has huge potential to help many things in the world, but there are also lots of ethical concerns. Firstly, big concern is safety, and so ensuring that the transformed bacteria don't transfer genes into the environment that could have unwanted effects. And also, if you're creating medical treatments like we're hoping to do, you'd need significant clinical trials to make sure that they're safe in humans. And when you're thinking about genetic engineering, there is a huge potential to do so many things, but it's really important to have some sort of regulation to stop it from becoming a slippery slope to more sort of controversial things. So with cloning and the production of designer babies, that's a current issue. But luckily there is a huge push for regulation, and so these things should be prevented.